In this house wanders the passion for art. It smells like fresh paint, and it is inhabited by a procession of a series of characters that talk about the celebrations, the work, and the contrast of the peasant landscape. In this house rest the unpainted facades, the always open windows of our towns, the mountains that serve as background to human joy, the streets, the pottery, the butterflies, and of course, the woman in love upon whom a vibrant scarf is always fluttering, signifying the vivid presence of a racial mixture. Here in this workshop house lives Fernando Portilla Garcés, folk painter and decorator of several cathedrals and basilicas, adopted son of Medellín and of all Antioquian towns, which have found in this octogenarian native of Pasto the artistic and humane capacity to bequeath valuable testimonial artworks of a peasant past and a regional history marked by Catholicism, brushstroke of color and vitality. Because that's precisely what life is, a brushstroke full of tones.
Que aprecio tanto la pintura que creo que uno hasta morirse no ha acabado de aprender el arte, porque el arte es para mí infinito.
This way, Fernando Portilla describes his life. His artwork has silently crossed borders thanks to his passion and his method. He has been placed among the best exponents of oil painting, which he has enriched with small gold and silver linings, making him the only one in that gender worldwide. His artistic career began at the age of 7 at his hometown, San Juan de Pasto, located in South Colombia, distinguished by its monumental richness and authentic relics of art. Framed by the Galeras volcano, Pasto, among photo engravings, intellectuals, plants and trees of the family's orchard and vegetable garden, witnessed the growth of a boy captivated by drawing. At the Jesuit school, he started his first brushstrokes, combining them with minor difficulties with other activities in the house, where day by day he watched his father Luis María Portilla work the art of photo engraving.
Él era el que me animaba a que no, que dibuje y aprende el arte y triunfe y no lo deje nunca en la vida. Mi madre se entusiasmaba y se animaba viéndome pintar, trabajar en casa, hacer dibujos. Hasta le hice muchos dibujos a ella.
Influenced by the classic artists of the Renaissance and by the active cultural movement of his hometown, mainly by the Teatro Imperial, located on the same block of his house and which presented all kinds of spectacles of the highest qualities, Portilla decided that his is graphic art and found inspiration in every colonial house. To leave printed evidence of his ability with pencil, he began to give up little by little his other passions, like soccer, sport in which he was very skillful because of his height, and the wonderful plays at the Teatro Imperial that he used to watch sitting on the top of the orchard wall of his house.
En mi juventud paseaba mucho porque me invitaban los parientes de mi padre, que tenían unas fincas a orillas del volcán Galeras. donde se observaba con frecuencia los cóndores que vivían en las rocas del volcán. Los destruyeron últimamente, pero de allá observaba la naturaleza, los paisajes, la perspectiva aérea y todo lo bonito y bello estético de la naturaleza.
His childhood friends grew up into lawyers, doctors, businessmen, but Portillo was the only one who chose the path that up until today continues fulfilling his desires and realities, art. He was admitted at the School of Arts at the University of Nariño, not exactly thanks to his qualities but to his artistic abilities. It was 1938. There he had the opportunity to be under the tutoring of three great masters and artists, the Colombian Ignacio Gutiérrez González, the Ecuadorian Luis Viera, and the Chilean watercolor painter Don Pedraza. The interest and talent that the young disciple showed made him stand out among his classmates and meet other artists, such as Master Alfonso Zambrano, with whom he founded an art workshop in Pasto, gardening closely, painting, sculpture, and decoration. After graduating from the School of Arts, and thanks to his abilities, he was appointed to decorate with frescoes, murals, and high relief works the Basilica de la Virgen de las Mercedes in Pasto, with total mastery of the techniques, including the use of gold and silver linings. His fame and recognition among the archdioceses brought him to live and move periodically to various cities and towns to paint and decorate churches. Through time, he became more and more popular.
Trabajé en los pueblos principales. El primero fue en Don Matías, que me tocó pintar 5 murales al óleo en el centro de la iglesia, encima del altar, en el presbiterio, de 3 metros por 2. Nos encontramos en la iglesia de Don Matías, en donde yo me hice cargo de dirigir toda la ornamentación y la pintura de estos famosos frescos al óleo, murales.
One day, he decided to leave behind his most loyal companions, his hometown Pasto, his Galeros Volcano, his art workshop with its additional enjoyment of endless nights and conversations about current affairs with other artists, his family and his only girlfriend, painting.
El tren partió un día de Popayán con Fernando Portilla.
It was 1948.
Tenía 28 años.
Throughout his journey along the parallel railways, which sum up more than 630 kilometers, the painter, using his creative imagination, sketched with brush strokes the possible future that awaited him. He arrived to the city of Medellín at a time when the tiny train stop stations of the past were already fairly important towns, and the main train station in Medellín, a big square full of people coming and going with great charm and formality. Qualifying adjectives that since that time had merited from him the people from Antioquia. He arrived overwhelmed with sensitivity and culture, also with a few pieces of clothing and his painting box elaborated by craftsmen in Pasto, keeping inside the palette that he still carries, plus some tubes of paint. The first month, he stayed downtown Medellín close to the neighborhood of Boston, at the house of some friends from Pasto.
Sometime later, while he was working on the decoration of the Church of Buenos Aires, he moved to a hotel. He was in love with the city that his Antioqueño's grandparents had described to him as a place for well-being and progress.
Uno se reunía en los bares con artistas muy hábiles, pintores, escultores y poetas, con el doctor Jorge Robledo Ortiz y muchos que ya no recuerdo, y la mayoría se han muerto. Y a hablar de arte, y las calles eran enormemente coloniales, buenas, y no había, y uno podía amanecerse en un lugar conversando de arte, y se iba, si quedaba la casa cerca del centro, sin ningún miedo.
He walked through a Medellín from the past, since nowadays he hardly leaves his house. Facades painted with a white painting called lime. Solitary streets bordered with trees, with businesses and tranquil bars, visited by many people from all the parts of the country who were highly educated, among whom Tartarín Moreira and Pedronel Gómez could be mentioned. Sharing out his time among his recently formed family, the murals and the high relief works at various Colombian churches, and the old paintings with folk stories, Portilla prepared his first exhibition in Medellín, which came to be in 1953 at the Galería de Arte Nacional, now in existence.
Fue un éxito el primero para mí porque entonces ya me conocieron los mejores artistas y compañeros que tuve aquí en Medellín, como Miro Botero, el maestro Rafael Sáenz, y los alumnos de ese entonces, que también me ayudaron hasta colocar los cuadros en la galería.
Allí.
There, along with important artists of that time, poets, painters, and sculptors, he shared the fruits of his knowledge. Sometimes with the wild lifestyle of the Bohemia, accompanied at times by poets and singers performing Colombian pasillos and bambucos.
Tarde te encontré en la vida encantadora criatura, mas no me aflijo por eso, más vale tarde que nunca, aunque nunca me fuera igualito te haría, siempre de llamarte mía, mientras un poquín me quiera.
La bohemia mía fue en todas las ciudades y pueblos en donde he trabajado. Me reunía siempre con todos los artistas, escultores y pintores, y hablábamos del arte contemporáneo y del pasado también, y sobre el futuro algunos, y todos los estilos y pensamientos de cada pintor, artista.
Peace and costumes that he admires, making the agriculture of work with mining, talks in his paintings, highlighting the generous fauna and flora.
Tengo mi estilo muy propio, muy personal, desde la preparación de la tela, porque ya no es el lienzo común y corriente como se preparaba anteriormente, ya es la preparación del cañamazo, una tela que no sé quién la fabrica ni de dónde es, pero aquí en Medellín la consigo. Me encanta el tejido, que es enormemente horizontal y vertical. Eso trabajo para que se vea Ya en un cuadro mío pintado se ve el tejido. Uso ya un lienzo bien antiguo que relama para dar ciertas tonalidades, valiéndome de la preparación de la tela o del cañamazo, como si fuera pintando un fresco. Uso el blanco que yo preparo como si fuera una acuarela o un fresco.
Durante 20 años, Portillo fue profesor de estética, dibujo técnico y geometría, pintura, modelado e historia del arte en entidades oficiales, privadas y en la Escuela de Bellas Artes de la ciudad de Medellín. Dictó clase en todas las ciudades e hizo parte de la formación de valiosos artistas, muchos de ellos radicados en otros países.
Most of whom have settled abroad.
Nunca he never wanted to work full time so he could have time to paint at home and prepare himself for multiple exhibitions
and for his most loved one, his own home, since every centimeter is covered with his colorful stories.
El principio, el pasado, la agricultura, la lechería, los campesinos con la agricultura. Ese fue el primer término de la obra, que lo hice en el proyecto y aquí en el mural. Aquí pinté a don Matías Jaramillo, que era el director, el que mandaba en la explotación mineral del oro, con sus obreros, trabajadores en bloquecitos extrayendo el oro. Luego pasé en este pedacito de mural que significa en la actualidad el trabajo de las mujeres, que en todas las manzanas y las casitas principales de aquí de Don Matías existe las fábricas de textiles especiales, tanto que se los llevan al exterior.
Sus más
His most recent works, The Past and the Present of the Town of Don Matias, in addition to some murals and the fresco in the living room of his house painted in 1997, along with a collage that integrates images, remind about his experiences and his feeling of an artist at the service of the peasant community, involved in playfulness, music and dance.
No me interesa que me compren varios cuadros y jueguen con ellos y los expongan en sus casas sin ningún interés intelectual artístico. Y mi interés es que me aprecien y coloquen las obras estéticamente.
Portilla keeps a little from here and there, trying to create his own style. Lines, lights and shadows, golden and silver linings, estylized necks that are wrought out from his memory, with no need of models.
Árbol, ¿no? El primer término más fuerte. Después de tantos años, entrar a esta iglesia y me parece que recién la he terminado, después de tantos años. Eso para mí es una satisfacción y me alegro enormemente. Durante mi vejez, porque ya tengo mis años.
Solo con el convencimiento de que es un medio para ser feliz, a way to be happy and to make others happy, and a legacy for his children and the children of his children. At no time he wants it to become a commercial option,
rather a way of going deeper into our roots and our idiosyncrasy.
Un artista con demasiada fama se cree el único genio en el universo. El arte se aprende con la experiencia. Yo creo que uno se muere y no ha acabado de aprender el arte. Tiene mucho en qué aprender y en qué dedicarse en su vida a crear.
A glitter comes out from his artwork thanks to the gold and silver contrast masterly put onto the canvas, attenuated with color. A glitter that can be seen in Fernando Portillas Garcés' own life. He's a live testimony, a never-ending inspiration, a person that has never cared about fame.
Y lo que aprecio y quiero en toda mi vejez y hasta la muerte, es seguir dibujando, pintando, creando.
Fernando Portilla Garcés, At the Threshold of Memory.